Hi all, welcome to my channel, welcome to my world. This is the world of Wayne. We've now got stages 53 to 56 of the Panini Collection Centauria collection of build the Ferrari F40. Now, if you remember in the last pack, we assembled this almighty metal cage here, and it's good because we're going to be starting stage 53 by putting the engine in this. Going to be a little bit difficult because we're going to start laying out where the pipes go. And if you remember seeing the engine, the pipes are all over the place. But before we get into any of that, I want to show you something from Mike Lane. Now, if you don't know who Mike Lane is, he's been doing mods for some of these models for years, from the DeLorean to the Ecto-1 to this one, which is the Ferrari. Now, if you remember, these are the old steering wheels, these are the old seat belts for the Ferrari. Now, I've taken mine off here. If you remember, the sort of like designs here were held on by plastic. They were coming off, even in my pictures they were coming off. Well, Mike's basically looked at this, and rather than just put an extra transfer on here, he's said, you know what, let's just scrap the whole thing and create a whole new high quality set. Now, the ribbon is a lot more seatbelt material, and it's a lot more rigid than this material here. As you see, this just flops around, but this is lovely and secure here. You've already got all the metal details on there, the brackets, absolutely everything. So when you put this in your vehicle, and I've done one seat at the moment just to show you how that looks, it's gonna look just like that. So this side here is the side with Mike Lane's belts, and the side with all the paper coming off here is the side that I still need to do. But I'm sure you'll agree, it does make a big difference. Now, down the bottom of the screen now, I'll put the link to MikeLaneMods.com website. You can see all the other mods for all the models that he does, but the seat belts are there as well. So if you want to get these for yourself, head on over to MikeLaneMods and you can get those now. You know what? That was probably the biggest amount of communication I had on the last video. Wayne, your stickers are falling off. Well, I knew, so we got that there. But I'm going to get cracking straight onto it because issue 53 is supposed to be a right pain. So let's see what you think. Let's get cracking. Okay, so on issue 53, they've gave us loads of parts here, but just because they put parts here doesn't mean they're going to be in the engine. But what we are doing is we're going to be taking the engine, trying to figure out where some of these pipes are going. We're going to have to position the pipes and cables in a certain direction because we're going to be mounting this into the frame. And as you can see, it's all about the pipes and where they go. So I think this one is going to take quite slowly, and hopefully we can figure out together where everything's going. So here it is, here's the engine with loads and loads of pipes coming off in all directions here. It's going to put that to one side because the first thing we need is a pipe that we had in stage 28. It looks like this. Now, I've got loads of pipes and God knows what else stored over. I had to look for it, but I'm sure this is the one that we should be working from. Now, I've got my engine upside down here. I'm going to point to a little nipple just there that we've got that pipe's going to go into. So it has got a little round end there. I'm going to put that over there using my tweezers to help me get that all the way in. And there we go, that pipe's in as well. And now, keeping it upside down, we're going to want to position the pipes exactly as it wants them. So, you know what, I've had to stop already because the picture here of all the pipes looks nothing like the pipes that I've got on this vehicle. And I've been meticulous about where I'm putting these. I've got extra ones on here. Nothing actually makes sense in these instructions at all. Well, you know what, for the first time I'm going to say it's beat me. None of these wires make any sense to the pictures from where we're up to at the moment. This, the only thing that does make sense is the wire that comes off in a white direction, in a Y sort of lead. We have one end going up here, the other end's going to come up towards this end of the engine. I've got no wires or parts which could even vaguely resemble, I suppose this one could be it, I don't know. I've got wires all over the place here, which just don't seem to want to be going anywhere. I've got this one here, not attached to anything. Just looking around here. They're just wires all over the place. So you know what? I'm just going to deal with what it is. I'm never going to see the engine anyway. It's just a testament to these instructions. They are absolutely terrible. And I refuse to go online and see how to do this. Because I said, this was bought in a store, so I'm relying on the magazines for that. So I'm going to work with what I've got and see where we get. So what we are going to do is put it on the frame. Now if I do need to move some of these wires around afterwards, I will. But basically the tabs on the bottom of the engine, here and here, just move this one out the way as well, here and here, here and here, are just going to go onto the frame in these points here. So gently I'll put this on and I will deal with any pinches or wires or anything like that afterwards. There we go. At least something's gone right. I've actually got the engine mounted to where it needs to be. So it wants me to put two S-screws in these holes here. So I've had to go through all of my collection of stuff to find those screws. Now these are going into metal. I already ensured that the engine's lined up. So that's one in that side and one in the other side. Make that nice and tight. We're also going to be doing the two S screws at this end of the engine here. So basically the whole thing is mounted in four places. Just get rid of any wire pinches I've got. Make sure when you do that, that the exhaust is going through this side of the engine there. That will mean that this end of the gearbox will actually fit flush to this side of the vehicle. So that's one side in there. I mean, it does look really impressive, but I just don't know what I'm going to do about all these pipes and wires, because I haven't got a clue where they go. Someone told me once when I was building this and we started to install them. Now you know what it's like building a real Ferrari. No one knows where they go. And there we go. The engine is now fully mounted in the frame. The good thing about that is that it does feel hell of a lot more secure now. So, but as you see, look, I've got wires going absolutely everywhere. I'm sure we'll figure that out in a second. I'm going to put that to one side. Now we want to put the bumpers into the front beam that looks just like that. Now this came in issue 52 and all they do is push in to the holes here. They're slightly asymmetrical, as I said, this side isn't the same as that side, but that's how that should look. We're then going to mount this to the engine cage. So this is just going to be going over the two holes that we can see here on this side, here on that side, but it's going to sort of be fed in. So if I show you on this camera, it's going to be fed in like this. All the way. It's pretty hard because we have got pipes and stuff in the way, all the way across until we're on those mount holes, and it's going to fit in just like that. Now that's going to be secured in on each side with H screws. So I've got that here, one in this side. Excellent. And then we just do exactly the same on the other side here. Now in the next image, they've labelled all of these pipes up. As a matter of fact, I'm going to show you the magazine. They've labelled them all up, but again, because of how detailed this isn't, they make absolutely no sense where these pipes are coming from. So I'm going to try my best and see if I can figure out where they are. Okay, welcome back. I don't know if that's anywhere like what it's meant to be, but on the top, I have got the other side of that Y cable here. And I have got a wire coming out from the centre of the engine, which is on top as well. And then underneath, it does kind of look like the picture, I have to say. The only difference is that the Y-shaped lead, I've got it going over this mounting point here when I think it should have gone under. But I've glued all of these in, so there's not going to be an issue there. I do have a spare wire just here. I'm not sure what that's for. I'm going to keep that there. No idea at all. But basically, we've got this is the Y-shaped wire here. This is part of the Y-shaped wire here. This goes to this side of the engine. I haven't got a clue. All these wires were coming out from that side of the engine there. This is the pipe from this side of the engine. We've got the big, big pipe going into here. We've got the smaller pipe going next to it. And I think that's everything. That was a living nightmare for something. You know what? You're never, ever, 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 ever going to see, let alone trace these wires back. But my OCD was driving me crazy there to get all of those in. So I have got two wires at the top, and I've got that spare wire in the middle. I'm not sure what that's for, but that nightmare is all there is to do in that stage. It does look good, don't get me wrong, just these instructions, they're driving me nuts. So in stage 54, again, they're giving us a wheel, but we're doing nothing to do with the wheel at all. I haven't even opened them, but we are going to be mounting some more parts to the engine cage that we were working on previously. So in stage 52, we had this bit of plastic looking like this with the hole on top. This is just going to go inside this cage section here. Little bit of a fiddly fit. So it's going to sit in just like that. Now this just pushes into the holes here. It's not glued in, it's not screwed in or anything like that, but it will hold its own weight just like that. Now we have got a little detail to put into the hole at the top there. That came in issue 50. So again, looking at all my parts, that took blimmin' ages. I found the detail they're talking about, which looks like this. We do have a couple of nipples on the side of this, or one nipple and one hole. I'm going to put this into the top here, and it says it's going to connect the three ends of the two tubes. So I've got one tube here, and this is probably the two tubes that I had that come out the side. I haven't got a clue, but let's have a look. So we've got one that's going in the end here, which I'll put round onto the side with the nipple. I mean, at this stage, I just haven't got a clue. I really do not have a clue. And then I've got this other lead here. And then, you know what? I can't even find a cable for the other end here. So I'm just leaving it at that. The cable that I've got free, there's no way that's getting up there. So it can't be that cable. So that means all I've got left now is just this cable that we had from the front. I haven't got a clue. I haven't got a clue. But as I said, it is what it is. I'm calling it. I'm not going to keep dwelling too much time on that. Now the cable here that I had coming out the side of the engine, which I didn't know what to do with, we've actually got an adapter to put on. This adapter came in issue 51, so we just need to put that on the end here. We're going to be attaching the oil tank. Now the oil tank again came in issue 51. This is enough to drive you nuts, I don't know what is, but that looks like that. That's just going to go into the holes that we've got at the side there. And once again, it's a push-in thing. So I'm going to push that all the way in. And into the hole that we've got on that side of the oil tank, we're just going to put that pipe that we just had with the adapter. And there we go. That's in. I hope I'm putting these in the right way. I haven't got a clue. Now, by the look of it, I've only got this one cable left. I can't see any other cables I haven't plugged in. But that was a living nightmare. If you've managed to follow along with the magazines, then my hat really does go off to you. I'm not overly bothered because I'm never going to open the engine up, but that is just absolute crazy. You're going to hear me say that so many times during this build. Now it wants me to install this bar, which came in issue 52, I believe. This is just going to be going, trying to figure this out now. It's going to go into this joint over here, just like that. It's going to be held in with an end screw, and by the look of the pictures, the hole on top here needs to be facing down. So it's going to go in that way. So I'll get an end screw. There we go. Get that screwed in all the way. And we've got a bar in there, but that's all there is to do in that stage. I wonder if in the next stage we're actually going to work with the stuff they give us. Well, we're going to find that out now. Issue 55. Remember, we had a wheel last time. In this one, we've got the tyre. And oh my God, I think we are actually working with the tyre and the wheel. This is going to be crazy. Okay, let's do that now. I'm actually in a little bit of shock, I have to say, that we're actually working from this. We've got plenty of screws in this one. We have got some springs. I've got some of those already stashed away, but obviously I don't think we're going to be using all the parts of these stages. Let's get that one out as well. Cool, we have got quite a lot of stages. I'm just making sure I haven't chucked anything. Cool. So in the center there of the rim, we're going to be putting the rim support in this part here, and we're going to be pushing this into the lugs that we've got in the inside. There you go, that's perfect. So it fits in just like that, nice and flush. We have actually done one tire before. So then we're going to be putting the hub in, making sure this goes, face down. So it's going to be going in this way, just lining everything up. That drops in like that. Perfect. We're going to be holding that in with some B screws, which come in this pack. Oh, it's like the old days of partwork models where what you had in the pack, you're actually working with. This is my least favorite build, just so you know, out of all the builds. Because of that reason, the instructions just don't make any sense. And unfortunately, the quality of the vehicle and the car are absolutely amazing. So it's just the instructions which really do let it down. And I hate to say that, Panini Collections and Centauria, but if I was writing a report card, it must do better. Definitely. Once we've done that, we're just going to be pushing this rim inside the wheel. There's no need to put any heat on this at all. That it's quite manipulatable. Just push it all the way in there, just seeing if it's got an outside and an inside. Nope, we're all good. All the way in on one side here, that looks good. Just checking the other sides in. Excellent. So we have now got a finished wheel, and that is all there is to do in that stage. Look, I've been showing you the centrefolds. There's the centrefolds from stage 56. What do we have to do here? We're actually going to be making another brake disc and caliper. We've done this before as well, so this should be quite simple. Just so you know, before I do that, this is stage 53. Haven't even opened it. How mad is that? Haven't even opened stage 53, but we've got loads of parts in there. Crazy. So stage 56 here, as you can see, all the parts that we need are in this pack, the way it should be. Let it go, Wayne. Let it go. I can't let it go. It's driving me nuts. I hate it. Right, okay. Let's get this out. This video, just so you know, for me recording this, God, these feel really good. These are metal. Absolutely brilliant. The discs are plastic, but the actual the supports are metal. That's brilliant. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to be actually just piecing this side of the brake disc to the other side. So when we actually line these up, stand by, it's going to make a disc. And there we go. It looks just like that. That looks really good for a brake disc. Look at the lining on it. I see, I will give compliments where they're needed. Now we're gonna mount the cover of the brake disc here. That looks just like this, and as you can see, we've got some holes in this as well. They're just going to go into the holes that we can see there, and it is just a pushing like that. And then finally, over the top, we're just going to join the other end of the caliper here. So that's going to go in like this here, and the other side, push them together like that. And that is one brake disc done. That looks really, really good. I'm so happy with how that looks. But that is all there is to do in that pack. Now, those wires were an absolute nightmare, and I'm not convinced they're right already or wrong, but I mean, the engine does look good in there, I have to say. I haven't got any free wires apart from that one that we had to bring out the front, so we are looking like that. All of the wires and the pipes went in okay on that four section there. I do have loads of parts left over still, not sure what they're to do with, but I'm not even going to go into that, we did that last time. But hopefully, we don't have to work much on the engine anymore, because I really am sick and tired of it. It looks nice, but God, I don't know. Have you ever seen me that frustrated in a build? It just doesn't make any sense. Look, this is what it's looking like. By the way, I did find the lead for this pipe at the top. Look, you've got two leads coming off of it now. Haven't got a clue. I found a rogue wire, so I've put that in there. But I don't know if it's right. It looks good, I have to say. But these instructions, if I knew this from the start, they were really good at the start, but coming near the end, they're bad. But anyway, listen, I think I badmouth this build a lot at the moment. So hopefully in the next four stages, it's not going to be too hard. We'll have to see. I do have them here, but I'm reluctant to look at them at the moment, because you just know I'm going to open a pack up and parts like we have parts 53 there have got nothing to do with the build until later on. We'll see. Anyway, I really do hope you like my moaning. If you did, please remember to give me a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed already, please remember to subscribe. Other than that, take care.